Hi, today we are looking at section 9.5, which is sum and difference identities. So these are identities where we are either adding or subtracting two different angles. So on this page, I've got our sum and difference identities for sine and cosine. So for sine of alpha plus beta, that's equal to sine alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sine beta. Sine alpha minus beta is sine alpha, cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta. And cos alpha plus beta is cos alpha cos beta minus sine alpha sine beta. And cos alpha minus beta is cos alpha cos beta plus sine alpha sine beta. So we'll utilize these in some examples. So, example, given angle alpha in standard position in quadrant 3 and cos of alpha is negative 3 over 5, angle B has a terminal arm in quadrant 2, and sine of angle B is 1 over 3, determine the exact value of sine alpha plus beta. So first thing I would do is draw out each of these angles. So this one's going to be our alpha. This one here is our beta. Okay, so alpha, we're told we're in quadrant 3. So we're down here somewhere. And beta's in quadrant 2. Now we'll fill in what sides we have. Cos, we know, is adjacent over hypotenuse. So we know that this is 5, this is negative 3. We will calculate what this side here is. For beta, we're given sine, which we know is opposite, over our hypotenuse. So if we do Pythagoras to find this side, essentially this side is going to be equal to the square root of 5 squared minus negative 3 squared. Which gives us 4. It's in a negative direction, so it's negative 4. Same thing with this one. So I've got C is equal to square root of 3 squared minus 1 squared. So that's C is equal to square root of 8, which is 2 root 2. Now it's a negative direction, so that's negative 2 root 2. Now if we look at our trig identities, sine of alpha plus beta is equal to sine alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sine beta. So we'll fill in our ratios for each of those. So we've got sine of alpha plus beta is equal to sine of alpha. Sine of alpha is negative 4 over 5 times cos of beta, which is negative 2 root 2 over 3. Then we have cos of alpha, which is negative 3 over 5. Times sine of beta, which is 1 over 3. So that gives us sine alpha plus beta is equal to 8 root 2 over 15 minus 3 over 15. We can combine that into a single term. So we've got sine of alpha plus beta is equal to 8 root 2 minus 3 all over 15. Now, sum and difference identities for tangent are a bit different. They involve fractions. So tan of alpha plus beta is tan alpha plus tan beta over 1 minus tan alpha tan beta. And 10 alpha minus beta is 10 alpha minus 10 beta over 1 plus 10 alpha 10 beta. Okay, this example, write each expression in simplest form and evaluate if possible. So we've got tan of pi over 6 plus tan of pi over 12 over 1 minus tan pi over 6 times tan of pi over 12. So we're going to try to match this up with one of our tan identities. So this looks like it matches our tan alpha plus beta. In which we have tan alpha plus tan beta over 1 minus tan alpha, tan beta. So this looks like it matches up with this. So essentially, this would be our alpha, and this would be our beta. So that gives us tan of pi over 6 plus pi over 12. Now, if we simplify that, that's tan of 3 pi over 12, which becomes tan of pi over 4. Now, from special triangles, you should know that that is equal to 1. That's when we've got sine of 8x plus cos of 3x minus cos x. 8x minus sine of 3x. So we'll see if we can match this up with one of our functions, or our trig identities, I should say. So if we have sine of alpha minus beta, that gives us sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta. Now this looks like it matches this. So this is our alpha. This is our beta. So essentially that'd give us sine of our alpha, which is 8x, minus our beta, which is 3x. We can simplify this. So we've got sine of 5x. We can't solve this any further because we have a variable in it. Okay, so next we are proving an identity. So we have sine of pi minus x equals sine of x. So what we'll do is write out what our subtraction identity is for sine and then fill it in. So we've got sine of alpha minus beta is equal to sine of alpha cos of beta minus cos of alpha sine of beta. So essentially, this is going to be our alpha, this will be our beta. So therefore, we can fill this in here. So we've got sine of alpha, which is pi, then cos of beta, which is x, minus cos of alpha, which is pi, sine of beta, which is x. Now, if we know our graphs of sine and cosine, our graph of sine looks like this. So at pi, we are at 0. So we'd have 0 times cos of x minus cos of pi. Cos starts up here. Looks like this. So at pi, we are at negative 1. So minus negative 1 times sine of x. That gives us sine of x equals sine of x. So our identity has been proven. Okay, example, solve cos 4x times cos 4, cos x plus sine 4x times sine x equals 1 over the domain from 0 to 2 pi. So we're going to look for one that has cos times cos minus, or sorry, plus sine times sine. So that matches our cos of alpha minus beta, gives us cos of alpha, cos of beta, plus sine of alpha, sine of beta. So therefore, this is really cos of 4x minus x equals 1. So that's cos x, or sorry, cos of 3x equals 1. Now our graph of cosine, we know, starts at its maximum value of 1. So we know x is equal to 1. We have compressed this graph, so it's going to, or sorry, it starts at this 1 at an x value of 0. We know it's going to repeat with this compressed period. So our period is equal to 2 pi over b, so 2 pi over 3. So if we add 2 pi over 3 to 0, we get 2 pi over 3. If we add another 2 pi over 3 to that, that gives us 4 pi over 3. Adding another 2 pi over 3 to that gives us 6 pi over 3, which is 2 pi. So these would be our solutions. Okay, now for example, determine the exact value of sine of 255 degrees. So these ones where we want the exact value of sine, cos, or tan, and it gives us an angle, which could be in radians or degrees. There's many different possibilities for solving them, because you can choose to use an addition identity to get up to 255 degrees or a subtraction identity. And you can also choose a wide variety of angles so that they work out when you add or subtract to 255. The key thing though is that angles that we choose must have reference angles that are special triangles. So I'll show a couple different ways to solve this one. So for example, we've got sine of 255 degrees is the same as sine of 45 plus 210. Because 45 and 210 give us 255 degrees. Now we've got addition here, so that means we're using our addition one, which is sine of alpha plus beta is equal to sine alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sine beta. So that means that this is equal to sine of 45, cos of 210, plus cos of 45, sine of 210. Now, before we go further, we'll draw out each of these angles so we can fill in our ratios. So 45 degrees is roughly here, 210 is roughly here. There's our 45. So that one would be 1, 1 root 2. 210 degrees would have a reference angle of 30 degrees. So this would be negative 1. This is 2. This is negative root 3. So sine of 45 would be 1 over root 2 times cos of 210. So that would be negative root 3 over 2 plus cos of 45, which would be 1 over root 2 times sine of 210. So that'd be negative 1 over 2. If we multiply that out, correct like terms,
That gives us negative root 3 minus 1 over 2 root 2.
Okay, so now I'll show you how to get this a different way. So we could also say that sine of 255 is equal to sine of 300 minus 45, because 300 minus 45 also gives us 255. So if we're doing subtraction, then we've got sine of alpha minus beta is equal to sine of alpha cos of beta minus cos of alpha sine of beta. So essentially, it would equal sine of 300 cos of 45 minus cos of 300 sine of 45. So we'll have to draw these out so that we can do our ratios. So 300 would be about down here. 45 would be over here. This has a reference angle 60. So its opposite side is negative root 3. This would be 1. This would be 2. This is 45. So 1, 1, root 2. So sine of 300 would be opposite. So negative root 3 over 2. Times cos of 45, so that'd be 1 over root 2, minus cos of 300 would be 1 over 2, times sine of 45, which would be 1 over root 2, and we end up with exactly the same answer. So, like I mentioned, we can do these ones a variety of ways. We could have chosen different numbers that added up to it than our 45 and 210. We could have chose different ones that subtracted than 300 and 45. Either way, we will still consistently get the same answer.